Mom's on the go, live from Rappy's in Boca Raton. I'm Dana from Hellerini.
And I'm Heather with Local Mom's Food. And we are
SoFlo Moms on the go.
Does anybody know what SoFlo means? Just to make sure. It's like,
I guess we just assumed that they did.
I know.
But
it's like a hashtag that people use for South Florida. So just in case you know.
So we're trying to reconnect with South Floridians. We try to show them cool places all over Palm Beach County. We spotlight them, but at the same time, if you come to visit the South Florida area, you'll know of fun restaurants and locales to go to, as well as just for common knowledge.
Yeah. So
always have technical difficulties,
yeah,
but
so
that is the fun.
So if you're online, yeah. So I'm not sure if I should finish and.
Do
you want to try to? I know. Oh my gosh. Okay. Yeah, so if you're on Local Mom's Scoop right now, for some reason I'm trying to reconnect. So that's what happens when you go live. You just never know what's going to happen. And so I'm going to see if it will.
Give it a few seconds.
Yeah, give it a few seconds. So we're going to stay on Pellerini.
Okay.
And talk about what's going on today. We're waiting for a few people to come on and go live. It takes a few minutes for Facebook to get out there.
Yeah. To get the word out.
And get things going. Hopefully you can hear us. We're like jamming out in here.
It's great music. I love the ambiance. Like, everything. You can't see, but the ceilings are really cool. This is totally like the wood is awesome. Also, when you log in to come in and see us, post in the comments. Say hi. So that we know that you're there and we can say hi back. We love to interact during our show. That's one of the reasons why we love Facebook Live, is because we can answer any questions that you have. And just say hi.
All right, we're going live again.
Here we go.
Woo! So I don't even have to post it, which is nice. Okay,
bye.
We're back again. Probably like, what happened? I was watching and then.
Where'd she go?
We're back on Local Mom Scoop. Let's pray that we can keep. It's a new area. So the Wi-Fi, they're still doing a lot of building here in this new plaza.
Amazing.
Yeah, we're at Rappy's. Hi, everybody. We're at Rappy's at SoFlo Moms on the Go today, a new restaurant in Boca Raton. And it's at this place called the Park Place. So they have all these like great restaurants coming in here and building. And
there's a Whole Foods I saw. So there's a lot. This is gorgeous. What was you?
Nothing. I think this was just vacant land. It's up near Office Depot. And so I'm sorry. I just saw something pop up on Facebook Live, and it says new. You can put a mask to give yourself a fun look, tap the magic wand. I'm not touching anything.
Know what? Google Hangouts used to have that, and I used to work down in Boynton Beach, and my marketing team was up in Radnor, Pennsylvania.
Yeah.
So we used to Google Hangout all the time for like our meetings, and I would randomly put like a mustache on, and they'd start cracking up, and it's kind of like filters.
Oh, okay. So
that's really cool
like
that they do that
filters.
Now.
Cool.
That's
so they're still spreading the word. We're trying to get out there. So if you're just tuning in, let's introduce ourselves one more time.
I'm Dana from Pellerini.
And I'm Heather with Local Mom Scoop. And we're here as SoFlo Moms on the Go.
Yay.
So at Rappy's, go ahead.
In Boca, yes. So Rappy's is a soulful, deli-inspired restaurant and bar. As you can see behind us is the majority of the restaurant portion. And in front of us, which you'll see in our after show, we'll take photographs, is a gorgeous, huge bar that has, it's like an open wall. What do you call that?
It's like the outside kind of seating bar. I love those.
I love that.
So you can sit outside.
That's so great. I think it's awesome.
This is a really cool place. And I think it's one of the only restaurants, they'd said, in the plaza that has a bar.
Why?
Girls Night Out. Anyway, so.
Girls Lunch Out.
Yeah. So if you didn't know, this is part of Burke Report's group.
Yes.
He owns a bunch of other restaurants in South Florida. And let's see, we've got Burt and Max's. So we were there, a couple weeks ago.
Correct.
Doing a live show there over in Delray Marketplace. And then
Henry's.
Henry's is over in Delray. That's considered Delray. Kind of more Palmy in like West Delray. And he's got Deck 84 over in East Delray. So loving it. So anyways, he's a cool guy. He's got a great vision.
I was going to say.
So what do they have here? I'm excited to try.
Well, they have breakfast, brunch, lunch, and dinner. And also, as we mentioned before, the full service indoor-outdoor bar, which we'll show you in the after show. Side note, after this show, we do an after show on Instagram stories as well as Snapchat. So you'll get an idea of the surroundings. You'll get an idea of the setup of the restaurant and the bar. I keep going back to the bar. It's been one of those mornings.
She's had a long morning. So,
already.
Yeah. Already. Always.
Yes.
Do you think we just show up here and everything's always smooth and perfect? No, we're just like everybody else.
We need someone to tape the before.
I know. If you could see us, we should do a before show of us just trying to get here with all the chaos that happens.
Hi, Dad. My mom and Dad are watching.
Hi. We love Mom and Dad. Thanks for tuning in.
Yeah.
That's over on Pellerini if you want to check it out. Okay. So,
also, before we go off of Rappy's and go into our huge, they do have a huge takeout area too. So you can get pastries, smoked fish, salads, basically any item, virtually any item on the menu. So that's good to know too, because my husband loves his lox, his Nova bagel, cream cheese. Get them in the morning, bring them home, have a nice little brunch at home.
Nice.
Have people over. Probably.
Yeah, if you've got little kids, you don't have to, like, if you're worried about the restaurant, get it to go.
Yep.
That's a cool idea. Well, we did order too, so we have food coming.
Can't
wait. Yeah, so we're going to try.
I'm having a Reuben with pastrami and french fries.
And I'm having a Reuben with corned beef with french fries. And then we're going to try a little appetizer here, so we'll see how we're playing it.
Yeah.
It's all about food and drinks.
How it's got to be. So, how was your weekend?
What did I do?
Went to Disney.
Oh, yeah. I'm like, what did I do again? I know. It's been a whirlwind since I got back. I think I've only been doing laundry for the last 4 days. I'm like, you people are like dirty people. So, here we go.
Some food?
Sorry.
Food
for
thought.
Talk about my weekend in a minute. So here, if you can see, hi, Tiffany just joined in.
Hi. Hi, Sarah.
There's spring rolls.
Oh, my God. These are so good. These are Rappy spring rolls.
Yeah, they're like their signature. They're the hottest thing, we were told, so we had to try. We're going to get the scoop here. I got the scoop. I got my side people helping me out. So Rappy Spring Rolls, it's got house-smoked pastrami, corned beef, oh my gosh, I'm going to be dying right now, Swiss, caraway braised cabbage, and Russian dressing for $7.95. So this is a great, inexpensive appetizer to share.
This is awesome.
Too.
Right. Okay, so you talk about Disney. I'm taking a bite.
Eat. All right, so I'll talk about Disney. Disney was great. It was cold, which I love, so we had to wear mittens one night. It was awesome. We went to the Magic Kingdom, and we ended up, it was great. And I know how to do it all, so I'll be writing about that soon. Tricks and tips and things. And then, unfortunately, Sunday was like a wash. It was so rainy. It was so gross. I was like, I am not doing Hollywood Studios in the rain. So we packed up and came home. But we had gone for the PGA show. Those of you who don't know, husband's in the golf industry. So we went up there for that. And he did a little of that. We went to Disney Springs. We went to Magic Kingdom. It was enough.
How was Disney Springs? I haven't been there yet.
It's great. They totally changed it and revamped it. And they have all this shopping and all these restaurants. They're still working on a lot of it, too. But it's cool. I mean, there's something for everybody there, for sure. So
I want to check it out.
All right. What did you do?
Oh, my God. You're going to love that. So I went on Friday to Connecticut. Actually, we flew into New York, my mom and I. And we went to go spend a girls' weekend with my sister. So we flew into New York, into JFK, and little did I know that there was protesting going on. I had no clue. We just got in our Uber and went to Midtown and had dinner with my aunt and my sister at a great little restaurant, El Quixote, and then we took a train into Connecticut, and we spent the weekend just like hanging out. We got our nails done. We ordered in Chinese food.
Oh, awesome.
I mean, we went to Marshall's. We went to Home Goods.
When was the last time you did that with like a girlfriend? Remember?
Yeah.
Just like going and doing errands and shopping. Now we have so much going on all the time. Never just chill out.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
It was so much fun. And then we did, we watched a lot of HGTV.
Nice.
Yeah. And then it was my nephew's 9th birthday. So we watched his favorite movie. Napoleon Dynamite,
which I love, by the way.
That was hysterical.
I love, like, the move at the end. That's, like, my favorite song, yeah. Thanks, Sarah Flynn. She said she just loves us together.
Thank you. So it was fun. And then I was supposed to come back on Tuesday, but Mother Nature had other, decision for me. So that's why I'm so close on today instead of yesterday.
Yeah, we should do Wednesdays, but my girl got snowed in. And so
I know. It was beautiful, though. It was.
But yeah.
And we're back.
And it's, what, 75? And it's an awesome day today.
Yeah, it's beautiful and it's really breezy. And
so good.
They are. Oh, and then this morning I did,
sorry, I'm trying to cough. I'm still coughing, people.
You gotta get her healthy. We need coughing remedies, people.
I need some, like, holistic coughing. I'm on prednisone. I'm on some kind of pill that helps. I don't know. It makes me go crazy. Pill that's supposed to help your throat. It's not hurting anymore, but it's just lingering. Now I think it's like a combination of allergies with all the, it's spring allergies and everything. Yeah, like pollinating. It's hard.
You don't feel good. Someone's got to listen.
I know. Mine doesn't matter. I know. Okay. Nobody helps me.
No, so I just did a segment this morning.
Oh, yeah. She's a busy girl today.
Luxurious Valentine's Day gift ideas. So I'll get that, hopefully, that segment
what's
later today.
What's WPB? Is that 25?
25, ABC.
In Palm Beach County. So she's my girl's on TV today. You're like,
yeah, it's been crazy. It's really been crazy. But I showcased a bunch of really cool ideas. I mean, the PGA Resort and Spa, I want to go there.
That place is awesome. They have, like, their own, like, do they still have the Dead Sea Salt?
The minerals? Yes.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, so any spa treatment you can go and play.
I think we're going to have to be doing a SoFlo Moms show there, maybe.
I got to talk to Karen.
She's got
to
work her magic.
And then also showcase Majestic Princess Cruises, which are intercoastal cruises.
Oh, cool.
Actually, that was a really creative idea. Like,
where do you take that out of?
Out of Riviera Beach.
Okay.
And it goes up and down. You see all the mansions of the beach.
Oh, that would be fun.
Yeah, and the food's delicious. They have entertainment. And they have all different types of cruises, but they're having a Valentine's Day one. So they wanted to focus on that. And then Helen Piccolora, who's, like, one of my favorite jewelry designers. And then Forever Young, which is like a med spa. And they're having specials on Botox and Juvederm and lip fillers and stuff like that. Perfect. Listen, if you know that your Valentine is doing this,
yeah,
they have amazing specials going on. So.
Cool. And you can lip and...
Okay. Love to do that too.
Motherhood, I know.
My mom or dad said chicken soup, just Jewish penicillin.
Can you make me some?
I will make you some.
You will?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Okay. Possible?
Whatever. Put the whole thing in. Whatever. Okay. I'll take it off.
We'll do it. For sure. But, so that's what we did this weekend.
Yeah. Let us know.
Crazy.
Let us know what you were doing this weekend if you're tuning in. Love to hear from all of our followers. Hopefully you can hear us. We're, like, jamming out in here and it's getting busy. The lunch crowd's getting busy.
Yeah.
So, I know. So, we love to always talk about what's trending and out there. And so trending in motherhood is Beyonce.
Those babies.
Go Jay-Z. What? So, so she's having twins. Yeah. Let's see. I don't know how old her other little daughter is.
She's 5.
That's a good age. Yeah.
Yeah, she's 5. I think it's great. She'll be able to help with
them. Oh, my God. Love it. And out of diapers, out of a high chair. Yeah. So, congratulations. Yes, I've had to. Yeah, no. I don't want to imagine that.
But what's crazy is that people are ripping her apart, saying that her announcement looks like it was a JCPenney portrait.
Why?
That's like, just let it be. Just be happy. Mom,
let's just
happy.
Support
it's
each other.
Yeah, she's having a baby. It's like, who cares? And by the way, JCPenney does a decent job, too.
So. JCPenney.
But it was cool. I'm excited for her.
That's
like
awesome.
Watching the whole celebrity pregnancy.
Congratulations, Beyonce.
Yes.
All right.
Please name the babies after us. If you have two girls, Dana, Heather.
Maybe she'll name her SoFlo. That'd be kind of cool.
She does have a unique name. So.
Yeah.
SoFlo. Sounds good.
Knowles. I like it. Right? SoFlo, Blue Ivy, Beyonce, Jay-Z. They do like a pair. I love it.
We recommend SoFlo.
Oh, wait. She needs two names.
So
and Flo. Oh, well. Whatever.
We're delirious.
All right, so what else is trending?
Valentine's Day.
Oh my gosh, I know. I gotta
Valentine's Day is coming up. I mean, it's 12 days away, so we have a little bit of time. But, you know, if you, especially, like, you get gifts for your sweetheart, but then you also, a lot of people do fun things for their kids.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
What do you think that food's here? I love it.
Even more?
All right, hold on. We're making space. We're making space.
Hold on one second.
Get ready. Oh my god.
Thank you. Oh my gosh.
That's insane.
Oh my gosh.
Thank you. Wow.
Thank you so much.
Sure.
Thank you.
Alright, so right here is my basket.
That is really pretty. Look at that. It looks amazing.
I can't wait to try that.
I think that's also my favorite pickle.
That's my roommate. I love these kind of pickles. Alright, you gotta show yours.
Look at how yummy.
Sorry, we're gonna just mange like right in front of you.
You could always join us. We're right here in Boca, Rappy's. There's a few tables available. They're getting kind of busy here for lunch, though. But so as we were talking about, like, what are you doing for the girls' Valentine's Day?
Well, I just I just wrote a post about, you know, gifts to give little girls and stuff. And when I was growing up, we just were into holidays, and one of the things my mom used to do was put, like, kind of like Easter, like, wake up with a basket at the end of the bed, and we just got, like, all these little fun little things, like an outfit or a t-shirt, or I remember, and I read about, like, colorful shoestring, like shoelaces, like they were rainbow, and
I know, she has memories.
I know, she was awesome, and she is awesome, she's so true. So, but, she's just in charge, she's in Philadelphia right now, but anyways, so, I probably would do something like that. I try to stay away from the candy because that, oh my god, that's like kind of a fight in our family with every holiday. Maybe a little bit of chocolate. Not chocolate, that can't hurt. So,
there are healthy attributes.
Yeah. What are you going to do for the boys? What are boys, like, what would you
boys
do for the boys?
Boys aren't really, like, Nathan's in sixth grade, so he's not really into the whole Valentine's Day thing. But for Gabriel, for his classmates, we're doing the whoopee cushion thing. I got them yesterday. So I'm making a little card, and I'll post it. I think I did a blog post about it a little while ago, but I'll post it on Pellerini and SoFlo's page, the picture of it, once it's done.
Yeah.
It's like a card. It says, whoopee! And usually it says, will you be my Valentine? But Gabriel doesn't want to ask boys to be his Valentine.
Okay.
So whoopee is Valentine's Day. He's going to be the new abridged version.
Yeah. The pickle.
Yeah. And they're going to be, they're so cute. They're like these little mini whoopee cushions. And I
want one.
I'm gonna get it for the girls.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
I had a whoopee cushion growing up. Did we talk about this before? I don't know. Spencer's.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta get the whoopee cushion. Loved it. I got in trouble because I used to sneak it under everybody.
I can see you doing that too.
I know. Crazy. Anyways.
That's what we're doing Valentine's Day wise. You're going out for Valentine's Day, are you?
Yeah. Going to the Addison. But I'm gonna get a sitter.
We're not going out.
Bring
him over.
Yeah. We're going to the Addison. I'm going to have a date night, so I think that'll be nice. We haven't really been out much lately to reconnect. Yeah, and, like, you know, we're back in school, and the kids are kind of having a hard time. Like, they can't go to bed, or they want to come out 100 times and get a drink of water and all that. And so sometimes by the time that all ends, it's 10 o'clock, and you're like, I don't really want to have a conversation. I just want to go to bed. You're tired, but you need to talk about stuff, so I think it's good. So plan those date nights. We talked about that in our little goals resolution segment.
So important. It really is.
Yeah, we'll have to find out. We'll post that episode so we can go back. We're talking about unplug nights and stuff like that. Even if you can't afford to go out or whatever, at least just unplug, disconnect, and, you know, hang out. So, what are you going to do? Oh, Super Bowl. Is that our next trend?
I'm like, Super Bowl.
Super Bowl. Oh, she's doing Super Bowl.
We're having a Super Bowl, like a little get-together with families, and planning some fun, like, sports-related games for the kids. And my husband is a huge foodie, so he's, like, so excited for the food part.
I'm going to take a bite while she's eating. It's not going to be pretty.
Oh, my God.
I'm not married to him. I'm not looking for a date.
So we're doing like the usual wings and all that fun stuff, the different dips and chips and all of that. So actually, actually, this is a good lead in to our question. Every week we have a question that we want to know from you guys that are watching. Who are you guys rooting for the Super Bowl? Is it the Atlanta Falcons or the New England Patriots? So definitely comment below. We're interested. We're taking a poll to see who's who's for which team. I came back from an entirely Patriots family household when I was up in Connecticut. And FaceTimed actually when I was up there with my youngest son who was wearing an Atlanta Falcons hat. And that caused a little bit of a contention with the cousins in a playful way. But yeah, so I'm voting for commercials, good commercials. I actually could care less about football.
Oh, I'm going Falcons, baby.
Yeah.
I'm a Dolphins fan, so even though Brady, you're cute, but I'm not, no. Even though I was born in New England, but sorry, I'm not. I'm a Dolphins fan.
Yeah.
We almost were there. We almost had it.
You guys had a good season. Well, I
tease me.
Knew that you had a good season.
I know. Well, that's how it was a big deal. So, yeah. So, and I used to live in Georgia. And
you did.
Uh-huh.
I used to be
an Atlanta Falcons. Yeah. That was like back in the day, though.
I know, but still, I didn't.
Yeah, I'm going Falcons. I'm going for the South.
I think I'm going Falcons, too. I have a hat.
Cool.
I accessorize.
I'll probably wear my Dolphins jersey.
I say, just you go and have a good time, watch the game.
Share the love, have fun. I do want to see the commercials, so that's the most fun. Who cares about the name?
Oh, I know, the commercials are the best.
Yeah, that's what everybody watches now.
A ridiculous amount of money on commercials, like a 30-second spot.
I wonder if it's like the only time in the whole entire year that people actually don't DVR and fast forward through commercials and actually watch commercials. That'd be interesting to find out.
I think it is because I can't think of any other real sporting event or even like entertainment, like the Oscars or whatever. They don't have as big of a...
I would DVR it if it gets to bed and
watch
fast forward. Yeah. It's good. Here, take a bite.
And I'm going to take a bite.
Talk. So... in trending, so we talked about the Super Bowl, so let us know what you're doing this weekend, and you know, we'd love to hear any of your favorite like recipe, if you make one or you love to eat. I'm like a big buffalo chicken salad. Isn't that amazing?
Bread dripping?
No, it's on your mouth. Want me to dab you? So,
that's a friend of four people.
I love buffalo chicken anything. Throw some wing sauce on anything and I'll eat it. That stuff is so good. And then, I love that show, The Kitchen, on Food Network. It's like all the different cooks, and she made something in a skillet. It literally was like a chili con carne with biscuits around it, and you just dip it. I was dying. So, I just need somebody to make it for me. But anyways, so let us know what you're doing and or what you love.
Like your favorite
food. Is it like burritos and chili?
Ever heard of that? Rotel?
Yeah, that's good too.
Yeah,
and cheese. Rotel. That's
what
like
is Rotel? It's tomatoes and it's like a mixture.
I think it's like a Texas thing too. Alright, so then, so we segued into food. Alright.
We're always into food.
I know, we can do that. We're so good.
We're so good we don't even realize. We were just talking about like Valentine's Day trending and then food wise. And you had mentioned you're going to the Addison.
I'm going to the Addison for Valentine's Day. We have a lot of Valentine's Day posts coming up. You just posted one I saw.
Yes, so I have. I try to. Well, the school that my younger boy goes to and my older one used to go to is a green school, and it's a healthy school, so healthy choices. So you cannot bring sugar, candy, or anything. Like, literally, if you have a birthday, you bring apple slices. It's kind of really good, I know. But, so it pushes you to be a little bit more creative when it comes to holidays and stuff like that. So, like the whoopee cushion was a perfect example of something that's not a candy, but it's a giveaway, something fun for the kids. So I just did one where it was have an amazing Valentine, and it's one of those little plastic mazes with the ball, and you glue it on. And then I have a few of like different Valentine's Day gift ideas for teachers to give them, like just a little something.
You're so DIY, I love it.
It's DINTERES. I cannot take credit.
I know, well, I think everything's on there now. Need a little inspiration.
What else? And then you tweak it to whatever.
Yeah, cool. That's awesome. That's so good. I think we have a Valentine's Day party. I don't know. I have to, like, it's on the calendar for school. I gotta check.
Oh, it's cool.
Kindergartners. We'll be full of candy and junk food and cupcakes. We're gonna go. I'm sure they'll go full throttle. So.
And then they'll be like, your parents, have your kids back.
And then I'll have kids bouncing off the wall all day.
Yep.
Yay, it'll be great. So, what was your post about with the, didn't you have a Valentine's Day fashion one I saw?
I had a business casual post. So, we are both actually working on a giveaway for Pink and Rappy. And I wrote a post about business casual attire. Because that happens, that's such a big concept.
I know.
No one really understands what business casual is. And if you look like a Merriam-Webster, which of course I did because I wanted to know, nice. It's like, nothing. There's like no real.
Well, it's very scary. It's easy for a guy, but for a girl, it's kind of like.
No, some people really push the ticket.
I would say like no bare arms, you know, no sleeveless, no, I don't know. Yeah, because I'm going to a Disney conference next week, and it was business casual, and there were so many women on a, were on a private Facebook page who were like, what does that mean? Like, you know, if a lot of these digital influencers are at home all day, and so it's not like you're getting dressed up and you're going to the car line or you're on your floor with your baby, and so you're wearing, you know, workout pants and...
But you're comfortable.
Right, right. So, I would say like a cute top,
pair of slacks, if you have to do denim, dark denim.
Yeah, I love dark
denim. No rips. I love rips. But
I know,
no rips,
so
nothing
hot.
Like that. Maybe a wide leg denim. I have a pair of them.
Yeah.
And then what I like to do sometimes is maybe like a white button down or something simple, and then I accent them with cool jewelry to make it fun. So like Pink and Rose just started their debut line of hand knotted and strung pearls. They're faux Swarovski faux pearls with Swarovski crystals, but they're really pretty. They make it like a little bit.
Yeah,
fancy.
I have some. I'll be writing. Coming. I love them. Thank you.
No, so that's what I wrote about. It wasn't really Valentine's. It was more like business casual.
Excuse me. The coughing. And I wrote about my fun little... I talked about Jovella's girls' boutique and design closet out in West Boca. It's so cute. Sorry, they only have, like, girl stuff, but it's really cute. And I just did 7 ideas for Valentine's Day gifts for little girls, so you can check that out. They've got some really great stuff.
Wasn't Rosie just there doing pictures?
Yes. Rosie, our beloved photographer, who took those great photos of us that we used for SoFlo Mom on the Go marketing stuff, she was out there doing a photo shoot this past week, so it was great.
Oh my god,
so,
that must have been so much fun.
I know. And then, I didn't get to meet her because I was in Disney, but I got to kind of like interview her, like via, you know, phone, email and stuff, with the senior editor for harpersbazaar.com, beauty editor. And so it was great. So you have to check that out because I asked her all these mom questions of like...
No, it was a great interview.
Yeah, like what can we use in 3 minutes and what's a must-have for your handbag and what's the replacement for Botox, like if you're afraid to do it, is there anything that you can do to, you know... So you have to check that out. That was some... I was like, ooh, this is great. I was like, here are all my notes, write in a post. I don't even have to like do anything. So when you're shopping in the cosmetics area, you can pull that up and check it out. And you can also click on the links and shop from there too if you don't have time.
Oh, that's good. You have it all linked out?
Yep.
So you don't even have to do... All no. You just click.
I made
and
it
then
easy
buy.
For you mamas because I know life
it's
is
swimming.
Easy.
Yep.
Yeah. So,
did she have one brand that she liked in particular? Was it all different ones?
God, everything was different. I mean, even talked about like drugstore stuff. You know, she was really.
See, that's cool.
Yeah, she wasn't like, you know, over the top like La Mer. You know,
I do want to try La Mer.
I did too. I know, $300 cream. But yeah, she was had some really nice different things for. So check that out. All right, cool. So, so blogging. We always love to give a blogger tip of the week.
Yes.
Because we know some of you might be thinking about it or
are doing it.
Or are doing it. We love to share what we've learned. We've learned to change hosts. No, I'm just kidding. My site was down all weekend. For something really dumb. And the customer service was ridiculous. So I apologize to all my followers and brands who were, you know, on there. It was, I'm
so
in
stressful.
Disney in the, like, Grand Floridian, like... So, yeah, nothing like... That's what happens, I guess, when you... have a website. So, but one of the things that comes across both of us a lot is what to charge.
Right.
You know, if you're not a blogger and you're tuning in, we do make money, actually. Because our voice is out there. I mean, Dana probably has, combined with social media, over 20,000, more than that. She has 13,000 Instagram followers, 6,000 Facebook followers. I mean, that's just
my stats.
I know my girls. Like, just to, you know, just to share, that's just two social platforms that she can share her, you know, and
opinion.
Her opinion, and people trust her. So, gosh, what is happening?
Wait, oh my girl.
Your girl, Amber.
Our
marketing guru here.
Oh, it's a spiked milkshake.
Okay, we just got a spiked milkshake. It's called the Grasshopper.
Is it Bombay Sapphire, green, creme de menthe,
creme de cacao?
Cocoa.
Creme de cacao. No, creme de cocoa.
This is insane.
Okay, hold on. I have to, like...
Alright. Do you see that?
By the way, we're going to eat more
when
we get off camera. Yeah. I just don't want to be like a total pig and be like, you know. Because that's the way I eat.
Ready?
All right, ready?
It's like a date.
Wow. It's like a party.
Wow, thank you.
Sorry. I've been on prednisone for like a week. Oh my god, I did read that it does give you mood swings. And I was crying the other day when my website was down and I was on the phone.
No, but that's like a natural cry.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, she gives me support. My husband's like, don't you cry to those people. And I'm like, I can't just get it up. And I was like, it's a prednisone, honey. I know, I gotta fix some more. We have to share the cookie.
Yes. Oh my gosh, it's so good.
So when you're like having a really bad day, you just get on military trail and just come on over to Rappy's and you're like, I'm a grasshopper ASAP. And this is like a happy drink.
Yeah, it is.
I love it. And the mint kind of like gives you a pick-me-up. And now we have fresh breath. It's like, you know, the Girl Scout cookie everybody's selling right now?
Thank
you. You know the Girl Scouts who are stalking you at Publix right now? Well,
that you're trying to not look at while you go into.
This is like for this is the parental like
grasshopper
Girl Scout for a parent.
I have grasshopper ingrained in my head.
The grasshopper, you gotta get it. It's so.
This
yummy.
Is really good. They have other ones too. So that's so cool. So
let's see what else they have.
So there's like a full menu here.
Awesome. I mean, you got the Jolt, which is Van Gogh. Double espresso, vodka, Kahlua, and Bailey's. So if you're like you need a jolt, you're like the coffee lover. They have Rocky Road, which is pearl vodka, Frangelico, and toasted marshmallow. Maya wants to know where we are. We're at Rappy's in a new restaurant over in Boca Raton. So you have to check it out. Let's see, banana sensation. So, I mean, the cocktail list is amazing, the wine list
is
amazing.
Look at your different milkshakes. Even, like, so kid-friendly, and by the way, this place is very kid-friendly, too, so you can definitely family-friendly. Strawberry cheesecake milkshake.
That would be amazing.
No alcohol. Only probably alcohol, something like that. But, like, that would be awesome. My kids would love that.
My kids would love that. So, yeah.
I don't know, it's 12:05.
Oh, okay. All right, so we're doing great here. So anyways, we're probably going to get wrapping up the show here. So we've got, we never talked about our blogger tips. We got distracted by the grasshoppers. Mom brain. Okay, so our blogger tip is,
a lot of people ask us, what do you charge for a sponsored post or something like that? And our answer is,
what is your time worth to you? Because you need to decide. I mean, I'll be honest, like, my prices have changed. Of course, when I first started out, I had a very minimal, you know, group of followers. And now I have this big following. And so, I've upped it. I've tried to make my photos better, and I keep growing, and I try to be better at what I do. But then as the better I get, the more I can charge. So I think if you're deciding to do this, you just need to think, like, I have kids, I have to do this today. I have this to do. How much does it take me to do social media for somebody, to write a post for somebody? How much is your time worth? And you need to back it out. And your prices will probably change throughout the course of your growth.
Yeah, as your experience, as you gain more experience, and as you're, I mean, you incur costs too as a blogger too, so you need to keep that in mind too, whether it's, you know, just your website or the photography, like the cameras and something you need. So just take that into consideration. It's really worth your time and worth. And we're so grateful for our followers, and we want to make sure that we provide for them the best reviews, the best products, and honest also.
Honest. And the best brands and the best restaurants. You know, Rappy's has been amazing today, so this is a great place to come for a dinner. Okay, so plans for the weekend, Super Bowl.
We have a Super Bowl party, and also we're starting flag football with the boys.
Oh, wow. That's going to be amazing.
Well,
we're almost done with soccer.
Oh, and I'm just starting with everybody.
Oh, God. Yeah, I can't wait our last game, and she's just not getting it. I'm like, come on, girl.
So, it always happens.
I know.
But she'll be perfect for next season.
I know, so it's awesome. So I'm excited to add on one more extracurricular activity now that she's done. So we'll see. Stay tuned. We'll see what that is. Gymnastics or something anyway. So we're going to end the show talking about a little bit more about Rappies.
Thank you so much for having us
here. Yes, Rappies rock. I'm going to move this shake out of the way. So thanks for the grasshopper.
Yes,
the cookie on top.
You.
We're going to finish that.
I know. Just to give you a heads up,
we have all these fun little cards here.
Do have happy hour specials, because they do have that full indoor-outdoor, probably backwards, but 2:30 to 7:30, there's a bar by the menu, half-price beer, wine by the glass, and select spirits at the bar.
Wait, 2:30 to 7:30?
That's like the best happy hour.
That's like a mom's
ever.
Happy hour. I mean, was Bert like calling our names? Because seriously. Late night.
Rappy hour. Oh, which is 9 p.m.
So happy hour for moms starts from 2:30 to 7:30. And then Rappy hour for all those young people that can stay out is from 9 to close. That's amazing.
That's crazy. And it's all, you know, half price wine.
Beer. Select wine and spirits.
At the bar.
Can't go wrong. Which is cool, and we'll show you out. You can sit outside, so you'll get to enjoy this awesome weather. It's really cool, so stay tuned for the after show, because we're going to show you some more video and pictures and all this on Instagram.
Yeah.
What else?
And also, what I love is we are big brunch people. We're huge brunch people.
Okay.
So it's so cool that you guys have a brunch, because we're looking for new places to go, and they're open from 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. on Saturday and Sunday for their brunch. They're open aside from that, but their brunch is 8 a.m. to 3 p.m. Saturday and Sunday. And what I think I'm most in love with is the Villager on Bloody Mary Bar for $11.95. Really, that's awesome.
That's amazing.
We're huge Bloody Mary fans, too.
Well, and I think what happens, too, is everybody's always asking us, like, where to go for brunch. And there's not that many places, and I think this would be a great spot for families. You know, you have guests in town and you don't know where to go. It's pretty casual, so if you've been out the night before,
I don't either, but if I ever do, and
I'm out late and I want to come and get a big brunch, this looks amazing. So.
Also, you can find out more information on Rappy's at rappysrestaurant.com. Facebook is facebook.com/rappysrestaurant. Twitter is Rappy's Boca. And Instagram is Rappy's Restaurant. So we'll have all of these links and everything beneath the videos, whether on our Facebook pages, our YouTube pages.
Yeah. We'll add everything to this
page.
We'll add everything to this live post. So you can find it there. We'll put it on the events page. And then we both have SoFlo Mom on the Go sections on our website.
Right, so if you miss any episodes or you want to look back to find out where Rappy's is or anything,
yeah,
it'll be there. Also, did we even say that we started our Facebook page? Did we start it yet last week?
I think so.
We started our Facebook page, so we are legit.
Yeah, we got SoFlo Moms on the Go. I think we have 164 followers.
So if you don't follow, please do so.
So we'll put all that information on there too, so you'll be able to find it everywhere.
You're going to be like, there they are.
And then I got a little bit of scoop, some secret scoop, that February 9th is National Bagel Day. So you can buy one, get one bagel with cream cheese before 11:30.
Oh, that's perfect.
That's a lot of time to get the kids up, get them dressed, and get out here.
Yeah.
Or don't. Take it out. Yeah. So you take it out. So
I think I wouldn't want to sit here with a bagel and a grasshopper.
Is that weird? Grasshopper and a bagel with cream cheese? No, not really. No.
It's milk and dairy. And
yeah,
all
it's like
together.
Breakfast in a glass. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I did read about that, trying to get people to eat ice cream for breakfast.
This is a good way to do it.
You get dairy, you get all your, you know, natural whatever. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So, leave any questions for us. We always go back and check the feed, from our shows and try to reply if we can. We try to make it a half an hour because we know you don't have a lot of time. And we're going to go eat this amazing, amazing lunch that we had. Did you have again the Reuben?
Yes.
And I had the Rachel. And then we've got this awesome Rappy.
Already done.
Yeah, we got to finish. Oh, man, this. It's amazing. So yes. Thanks to Rappy's today for
thank you very much.
Being our sponsor and hosting our lunch. And I guess we'll see you.
Not next week?
No, I'm in Disney again. Stay tuned. I got a Disney Moms conference that I'm going to, and so we'll be sharing some stuff. But we're going to do a special edition, another special edition. Superbowl special edition. So stay tuned. So when you're just sitting there and you're bored out of your mind and the guys are getting all crazy, and you can tune into our Facebook Live show.
Exactly. We're so, more exciting.
Stay tuned for the time. We're working that out. So.
Yes.
All right. Thanks for tuning in.
Thanks,
bye.
Everyone.
I know.
That's a reach. Yeah.